Welcome to this Cogent DataHub Tunnelling video. We're going to configure tunnelling in three steps. In step one, we're going to connect the DataHub to our OPC server. In step two, we're going to tunnel the data to the DataHub on the client side. And in step three, we're going to read the data into our client application. So here we are in Windows 8. And this is my OPC server machine, and you can see I have the DataHub running, and you can see that I've already configured a connection to an OPC DA server. If we look at the data, you can see data in a W8DA domain, and this is the data being updated from our DA server. I want to add another connection to collect data from an OPC UA server. In this case, I'm just going to connect to the OPC Foundation sample server and I've tested our connection. And I want to load all of the points in the server, and I want those points to be stored in a data domain locally here called W8UA. Click OK and apply. And you can see that we've made our connections running, and we have a new data domain showing up, and here is the data coming in from our UA server. So that has completed step one of the process. We've connected our data hub on the server side to our OPC servers and collected data. Now I'm going to go over to the client side, and here we are on my Windows 10 client machine. I'll go ahead and start up the DataHub and double click to bring up properties. If we take a look at the data here, you can see we just have two default domains. There's no points here. We've got an empty data set. So I'm going to come back, and then I'm going to configure a tunnel mirror connection to the data hub over on the server side. To do this, we click Add Master, and we're going to type in the IP address of my server machine. And over here, I'm going to read it in. We'll just keep the same names as we have the data domains on the remote side. We want to read out of the W8DA domain. Click OK and apply. And you can see there is a new data set on the client side with the DA values coming across the network. Let's add another tunnel connection. This time I'll read it into W8UA, and we're reading out of the W8UA data domain on the server side. And press OK and apply. I have two tunnel connections running. If we take a look at the data, there's our DA data, and here's data coming across from the W8UA data domain. So that's completed step two of the process. We've now tunneled the data from our server to our client machine. So let me go ahead and open up my client program. I'm using the OPC Quick Client, and I'll just go through and configure a connection to the local data hub here, local machine Cogent Data Hub. Add a group, I'll call this W8DA. Reduce the update time a little bit. And then I'll read in some items from that local data hub. And there we're reading in values from the local connection to our local data hub. I'll go ahead and add another group this time. For the UA data, and we'll select some information just grab a few of these. And there we have it. We've completed step three. We now have OPC tunneling from our server across the network to our client in three steps, and we have live data updating across the network. Now, before I finish, I just wanted to mention a couple of points that are different about DataHub tunneling. First, you'll notice we made a couple of network connections here, tunnel connections. With any Cogent DataHub license that enables the tunneling feature, you're not limited to the number of tunnels you can create. So we have two tunnels here. You don't need to license the program for individual tunnels. The second point I wanted to make is that the data is updating whenever there is a data change on the server. There's no polling going on here, so we drastically reduce the amount of network traffic involved in tunneling. Third, we're mirroring the data across the network. So when we make a tunnel connection, the DataHub on the server sends a copy of all of the data in the specific domain we've chosen, and it's mirrored on the client side. Now, this is very important in case there is a network interruption and we lose our connection. The client program can continue to operate with the last known good values that are in the local copy of the DataHub. So the client doesn't block waiting for the network connection to come back. And when the connection is re-established, the DataHub on the server will resynchronize and send new data across to the client. So there we have it, OPC tunneling in three steps. And oh, if you hadn't noticed, we also have OPC DA and UA conversion here. We're doing tunneling and UA DA gateway in the same configuration. Our client program here is reading, this is a OPC DA client, and it's reading both DA and UA data from our local data hub. The client program doesn't need to know where the data is coming from. Once the data is in the data hub, it looks the same to the client making a connection. So we have tunneling in three steps combined with UA to DA gateway and much more, all in one easy to use program. Now, if you'd like more information about some of the tunneling features we've not mentioned in this video, then please contact us or see our online documentation at cogentdatahub.com.